We really enjoyed putting it together, and we enjoyed writing it. And we really felt the presence of the Lord when we was writing this song, because it dealt with us on a one-to-one basis, because we kept saying to ourselves, every time he just loves us more and more. And every time that I keep sinning, does he still feel those nails? Are we crucifying him all over? For my transgressions, and they paid the price for all the time. When he gave his life for me, at a hill called Calvary, there's something else I'd like to know. Does he still feel the nails every time I fail? Does he still hear the crowd cry, crucified again? And I cause him pain, then I know I can change. Just can't bear the thought of hurting him. Seems that I'm so good at breaking promises, and I treat his precious grace so carelessly. Does he still feel the nails every time I fail? Does he still hear the crowd cry, crucified again? Am I causing him pain? Then I know I've got to change. I just can't bear the thought of her. You know it, would you say it with me?
I cried, holy.
okay. We put it off all we can. You parents, you better watch out now. Kids, I want the kids to stand. I want all the kids to stand. Y'all are in trouble now. See, I came up with a little song, and I sold it, but I came up with a song that sort of broke the monotony of my, you know, inspirational stuff that was geared towards the kids. So, kids, I want y'all to show these people how much spirit you have. I want you to really get into this song, okay? And in fact, excuse me, is that your hat? Let me borrow that.
Yes, sir. I thought
I adjusted. There we go. All right. Are we ready? Hit that thing. Ready? All right, kids, come on. Let's get with it now. Come on. Don't make me have to go get you. Come on.
Well, normally at this point, you hear me singing, how you doing that inspirational thing? So, but now you're probably wondering, what's going on? Is this really starting to sound like one of those rap songs? Well, let me tell you what the boy's up to. You see, I like rap music in the bebop group. Sometimes I gotta admit, I close all the doors and wave my hands around and I face the floor. But then I crack up laughing. I gotta stop, I gotta face the fact. The boy don't get pop. See, I grew up in a state where the grass is blue. And if it's gonna be believable, it's gotta be true. He wants to know if that's a truth or not. He has a list of reasons not to believe, like doubt, disillusion, hypocrisy. It's gonna take a lot to break through this wall, so it's gotta be true or nothing at all. It's got to be true. I gotta believe in what I say I believe. It's got to be true. Even when the body of Jesus watching me, it's got to be true. Every single minute of every day. It's got to be true. Come here. There you go. It's got to be true. It's got to be true. I gotta be living what I say I believe. It's got to be true. Even when the body of Jesus watching me, it's got to be true. Every single minute of every day.
I want you to stop the tape. Alright? Think we should turn it around on? Rewind it. We're gonna. What's your name? Huh? Everybody, this is Emily. Okay. How are you? All right, now, I want just the parents to stay. All right, where's Pastor Cyrillus? Come here, sister. Come here. Okay. Where is our police? I'll come get you. All right. Yeah. All right, start it.
Sometimes you gotta admit, I close all the doors, wave my hands around, then I face the floor. But then I crack up laughing. I gotta stop, I gotta face the fact. The boy don't be a pop. See a grown man stick where the grass is blue. And if it's gonna be believable, it's gotta be true.
G-O-T-T-O-E-T-R-U. Come on. G-O-T-T-O-E-T-R-U.
You know, I've been thinking about giving up my inspirational stuff to do this full time. And I think I got the haircut, the hat, the backup. The gloves. Not good. Thank you. Here's your hat back. Thank you. Well, I think Pastor Cyrillus has really, I think we found her calling. I really did. She had some moves going on. I like that. That was cool. And who says a pastor can't get with it? I like that. Thank you so much for y'all helping me out here. But one thing, when I get to heaven, I want people who have been in my concerts to be able to say is, you know, David may kid around and everything, but he has a heart that serves the Lord. And I want somebody to be able to walk up to me and say, it was because of you, David, that I made it to heaven. It was something you said, something you sang. Thank you. Thank you. Kids, you think we should shake these grown-ups up a little bit more?
Yeah?
Well, how about let's go in a little bit of Sundays on the Way. Does that sound all right? For those of you who don't know, no, not this blood for you. Let's do Sundays on the Way. How many like Carmen? Whoa. All right. If y'all like Carmen, then while I'm doing the song, I want to see y'all get into it. I think Pastor Cyrillus asked me when she got our demo tape when I first met her, "You're going to do that song about Sunday, right?" Well, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. It's in there. I leave no house without Sundays on the Way. He's saying like this, so this means it's not rewound, David, so I need you to talk, okay? So, actually, I want to thank everybody for inviting us out. You have a beautiful little town here, and I certainly hope that you guys will invite me back again to be with you here in Waxhaw. I see your commercials sometimes about your furniture going on. And you know what I think is cool about that? Is that the man who is doing that commercial, sometimes he puts his own advertisements away to read scripture. I think that is wonderful. Because that in itself is its own advertisement. The man needs to say nothing about it. So, without any further ado, let's get on with Sundays on the Way. Are you ready?
celebrate how they crucified Christ.
Hold that truth.
And he died on the phone by his bed. Yeah, he knew to call an old faithful friend. He would know for sure he was dead. He said, "Now, Ray, please tell me, my plan failed." Oh, Ray just laughed and said, "Your feebleness, the dude is dead." Ray. Yeah.